What's good, y'all? It's your boy Kenny Bo, and I'm back with another YouTube video. So I got a question the other day in my DMs, and I kind of told him the answer, but I'd rather make a video about it because, like, that question was very deep to me. You know what I'm saying? Somebody asked me, basically, do you still believe in love, even after everything you've been through with women? And it was difficult to answer because it's like a part of me wanted to say, I don't believe in love because, you know, people love to glorify that shit, but they don't really take that shit like seriously, like, you feel me? Like, but then there's another part of me that says I still do, you know, because I genuinely believe in true love, you know what I'm saying? Like that shit is like, it's special to me, like, have someone, you know, that has genuine feelings for you. And meeting someone who falls deeply in love with you, like, that's one of the most, like, to me, that's one of the most best feelings in the world. But I never got to experience that. So it's like, you know, I've generally fell in love with somebody else, with people first. I feel like no one that I've ever dated had genuinely fell in love with me. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I was just there. You know what I'm saying? Like, I feel like they was just there. They really didn't, like love me for real. Like, I'm not saying this to be sad or anything. Like, you know, that's what I've been through. Like, you know, like, it's tough. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, falling in love, bro, it's like, it's tough. Like, you want love, but then it's like, at the same point, at some point, you just gotta, you know, give more love to yourself. So I feel like at the moment, that's what I'm trying to do right now. Because I'm not in the right, like, headspace to be in a relationship right now. I'm really not. Because I'm clingy, you know what I'm saying? Like, I know most girls don't like clingy niggas. I don't know why, but it's like, you know, that's just the truth. You know? I fall in love really, really fast, which is, like, you know, a problem that I've had for, like, years. Ever since I was in high school, like, I always fall in love too fast, man. Like, I don't know. It's weird. It's weird. It really is. But it's, like, you know, like, that's why I tend to, like, nowadays, I tend to keep my guard up because it's, like, I really don't trust no one. I really don't, like, I really don't. I don't trust no one. Like, my trust issues are messed up at the moment. So, you know, I'm trying, though. You know, I wish things were different. You know what I'm saying? And I know sometimes y'all get tired of me about talking about my love life and what I gonna be going through. I be getting tired of that shit too. But it's like, you know, that shit never escapes my head. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm always, like, in my head. Like, I'm always overthinking about everything. Like, what if I don't find love? Like, what if nobody likes me? Like, what if I, you know, die alone? You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, like, it's shit like that. It's shit like that, you know what I'm saying? That really, like, bothers me and bugs me. And, like, I try so hard not to overthink about that stuff. I try so hard to, like, distract myself from other things just so I can, like, get my mind off of shit like that, you know? And it's hard. Like I said, this shit is hard, man. Shit is hard. Like, you know, I don't know, man. Shit is difficult sometimes, bro. You were thinking you in love, but then all of a sudden they really, all this time, they didn't really love you like that. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know. It makes me sad sometimes because it's like, I know I'm a good person. I know I'm a good guy, you know, but it's like, I don't know. Like I said, I'm not trying to get sad right now, but it's like, I don't know. Shit like that makes me sad. Like having someone like actually care about you and like having someone that like falls in love with you, not just for what you can do for them. Like that. That's some shit I never had. You know what I'm saying? I never had that feeling ever. Like I never had a down ass female when it came down to it. I never did. You know? Everybody just left. You know what I'm saying? When shit hit the fan. You know what I'm saying? When I was going through my emotions, everybody just left. You know what I'm saying? Everybody gave up on me. You feel me? So it's like, you know, I don't know what to expect. I don't know who to trust. Like, I really don't. Like, at this point, like, I don't really care who leaves out of my life at this point, to be so real. You know? Like, I don't know. Like, shit is different. Like, shit is weird. Like, I want love, like, I want to be loved, but it's like, I want to be loved by the right one, like, you know, like, I want, you know what I'm saying, but I know that I gotta focus on myself, you know, I know that, I think that's the best thing for me right now, is focus on myself, make sure my mental is straight, because right now, my mental is, like, in shambles. One day I'm sad, one day I'm happy. One day I feel like life is amazing, the next day I feel like life is terrible and I wanna die. You know, like it's shit like that. Cause like it's this shit that goes on in my mind. Like I'm really like closed off from a lot of people. Like I don't open up about a lot of stuff that goes on with me to anyone because I feel like I'm disturbing their peace. So I don't wanna feel me. I don't know. Like falling in love is like it's tragic sometimes, man. Like, I don't know. Love is weird. Like, that shit is weird. Like, you don't know if that person gonna leave you for somebody else. And I'm talking about having anxiety while in a relationship. That shit is not for the weak. It's not. Well, I've experienced that too. Like, I've experienced dating somebody with anxiety. But I still got did dirty. Well, actually, no, I didn't. I was the anxious one in the relationship. Because, like, I don't know, like, is he gonna leave? Is he gonna cheat on me? Am I not good enough for them? Like, that's some of the stuff that I ask myself. Like, because I've experienced so much heartbreak in my life. I've experienced so much people stabbing my back, you know, leaving me, you know what I'm saying? Leave me in the dust, you know, telling me they're gonna stay down when damn near will. Knowing damn well they didn't, telling them they're gonna break up with you, you know, like that stuff hurts. Like that really hurt me, and you know I don't. Like sometimes, like when I talk about it, I get emotional. But it's like for some reason I'm not emotional right now. It's weird, cause I don't know. I don't cry enough tears, man. Like. Heartbreak to like losing 3 people in 1 year, losing 2 friends to gun violence in the same week. Like never experienced that. Like I never thought I would experience that. Losing my foster brother to gun violence. I never thought I would experience that. You know, like that shit made me hurt. Like that hurt me. Like I feel like at that point I was already damaged. Like. My heart was damaged when, like, I started losing people back to back to back to back because I could never grieve. Like, when my brother died, I didn't even have a full time to grieve. I was, when my brother Isaiah died, bro, I didn't have a full time to grieve. I was told he was dying a week before his funeral, you know, and a month after he passed away. Like, I didn't even know he passed away, you know, and, like, that really, really hurt me because it's like, I didn't get a chance to talk to him before he died. I didn't get a chance to, like, say my last words. I didn't get a chance to hit him up. You know what I'm saying? We lost communication, but we weren't on bad terms, though. It's just that we just lost communication. You know what I'm saying? We were both, you know, dealing with shit in our lives. So it's like, you know, that's something I can understand, but I still feel, I don't feel guilty, but it's like, I still feel like, fuck, man, like, I should have, you know, came back in contact with him before he passed away, you feel me? Like, you know what I'm saying? You know, so I wouldn't have to be like this, man, finding out a month later after he died that my foster brother passed away. You know, like, that, I will never forget that phone call. I'll never forget that, bro. I'll never forget that. Cause that shit, like I've lost people in my life, but Isaiah's death hit me harder. Cause it's like I've never lost I've lost people to gun violence, but like I've never lost someone so like close to me to like, you know, someone that I've known since I was in diapers. Like, I would have never thought that someone I've known since in diapers would doubt me like that. And it's like, I get emotional talking about this. I'm bad, my bad, y'all. Fuck. Cause it's like, it's crazy. Like, I don't thank him enough, but sometimes I be taking God sometimes, cause it's like, I'm still here. You feel me? I'm still, you know, breathing. You know what I'm saying? Living and breathing, you know. You know, there were times where in my life where, like, I thought I wouldn't, you know, live. I thought I wouldn't live a long life, you know. Like, sometimes I be thinking, damn, I'm finna die young. You know what I'm saying? Like I be thinking about the most darkest shit ever, man. Like, I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. Like, it's just that, man, it's like, it's crazy. Everything is crazy. I still go through pain, man. I still go through pain on a daily basis, man. Like, you know, like, I don't know. Some things is just, they say that you can't be sad over stuff you can't control, which is true. You can't. And so, you know, wouldn't I have, you know, communicated with my brother before he passed? It probably wouldn't have changed the output. I really hope it would have. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, anybody can get caught anywhere, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's the thing. Like even with, like, I think yesterday, a couple days ago, there was a shooting at Michigan State's campus. I'm like, damn. You know, like, we live in a hateful world, man. Everybody wants peace, but it's like, there are people who aren't at peace with themselves. You know what I'm saying? There are people who inflict pain upon others just because they've been through that hurt. You feel me? But me, I would never do that to no one. I'm not saying I would. I'm just saying. Like, we live in a hateful world, bro. You know what I'm saying? We live in a world, I feel like, where it's like some people just don't care about nobody else but themselves. I mean, you know, but the weird thing about it is that most of the time, you gotta look out for yourself before you look out for anyone else. You know what I'm saying? That's the weird thing about it. Like, this life is weird, bro. It's like people tell you to always be kind to others, but if you don't become an asshole to get your respect, bro, then people aren't gonna respect you. You know, that's what I'm dealing with. Like, I'm still a nice guy, but it's like I'm not gonna tolerate no bullshit because I done been through too much. I ain't got time for nobody to telling me I'm this and that. They wanna leave my life. Like, at this point, if you wanna leave out of my life, you can go. I'm sorry, the door is always open. But once you leave, that motherfucker ain't finna open up for you no more. You know what I'm saying? That's what I'm on now, man. Like my trust is, like, fucked up. Like, my trust is really fucked up at this point. Like, I swear to God. and YouTube might flag my video for cussing too much. I don't care. This is really emotion that I'm feeling right now. You know, this is real raw emotion. And I know people don't give a fuck about a man being emotional. That's just society, you know. But it's like, you know, I'm just telling you, man, like all the men out there, bro, don't be afraid to show your emotions. Don't be afraid. Don't hide it, bro. If you got something that you feel that you want to speak on, bro, speak on that shit. You feel me? Don't let no one ever tell you that you're not allowed to express how you feel. Don't let no one ever tell you that. No one. I don't give a fuck if your family. No one. Like, that's the problem. People wanna put men in the ain't shit category because they're emotionless or they're nonchalant. No, it's just that a man that has been through too much in his life isn't gonna give a fuck about what's gonna happen to him next. It's not. That's the stage I'm at. Because I done been through so much shit, like, next person who try to hurt me, I wouldn't give a fuck. That's just the thing I'm on right now. I wouldn't care if a motherfucker try to hurt me next. I really don't. Like, what's next? You know what I'm saying? Like, what's next after this? You know what I'm saying? I already don't experience this type of hurt. What the fuck is next? Like, I'm dead ass. Like, what the hell is next? So, you know, that's a little, you know, something I've been wanting to, you know, get off my chest. Like I said, I still believe in love, man. I really do. But it's like, you know, at this point, if I ever, like, get with a girl or get with somebody and somebody, you know, who really has genuine feelings for me and really, like, you know, cares for me deeply. At this point, bro, I'm just telling my bro, I don't want you to love me like that, bro. You can love somebody and still do them dirty. That's what I've learned. You can say to a person or you can show a person that you can love them as much or you can love them right, but that person can still cheat on you behind your back. You know what I'm saying? That person can still, you know, do, you know, say some disrespectful shit to you. You know what I'm saying? That person can do all types of shit to you. Everybody's got a hidden agenda. Trust no one. Trust no one, bro. Because everybody's got hidden agendas. People, you know what I'm saying, will use you to heal their trauma. You feel me? People will use you to heal theirs. People will use you as a second option because they're trying to get over their ex, which I had to deal with. I was a second option to this girl. You feel me? Because she was still healing from her trauma, and she used me to heal her trauma, and she left me. And she went back to the same dude who broke her heart. You know? I'm not going to say what he did. Actually, fuck it. You know, dude had to hold on the baby with another girl while he was with her. And she went back to him. You know? And I'm not talking bad about them. It's just that if you're healing, bro, you gotta elevate, bro. You can't be that fucking miserable going back to an ex who did you dirty. I'm not even that miserable. I'm not. And I'm one of the most saddest niggas on this earth. But I'm not even that miserable to go back to my ex. I'm just saying. You know? So, yeah, man. That's the end of this video. If you are new to my channel, subscribe. If you are not new, always a like and comment. Turn on my post notifications so you'll know when the next time I'm posting. You feel me? Yeah. It's your boy, Kenny Bo, and I'll see y'all later, man.